path of bhakti and the path of jnana is helping each other. Path of self-effort and the path of surrender is nothing but a complementary path to each other. They complement each other. People ask me, you are such a big enlightened master, why do you worship Dakshinamurti? Why do you put the vikra? Why do you do Kumbhabhishekha? Path of surrender and the path of self-effort. Both of them are helping each other. So whatever you know, you think as meditation or self-effort, that will be encouraged, that will be helped when you surrender. When you surrender. A little bit of surrender, a little bit of worship will be a big technique for you to go into your path. So from here also wave will come and pull you down. From here also you will move. Actually, enlightened master is a person. From outside, by his techniques and teachings, through his techniques and teachings, he pushes you. From outside, he pushes you. He makes the TPS fall down. From inside, in the form of grace, he just pulls you. Outside, I push you in through meditation techniques and teachings. From inside, I just. So the master does both the job. Pushing from outside and pulling from inside.
What makes going up?
Here comes what makes going up. That is where actually problem starts. And actually, if you are deeply interested only in the Annamaya Kosha pleasures or the Annamaya Kosha sufferings, not only Annamaya Kosha pleasures, Annamaya Kosha sufferings, if you are happy with Annamaya Kosha sufferings, then naturally you will start staying with that.
How can anybody be happy with sufferings?
You don't know. That's what we are doing actually. We are very happy with our sufferings, you don't know.
But even while meditating, sometimes you feel more for something.
Sometimes it is very.
Means the TPS is high.
No, but then after some time you feel that it is calm down.
Means you are falling, the transit period.
Children, if we take the case of children, whenever they go and play, they have never had enough. Even if they play for 2 hours, they will tell no. Does it mean that they are?
Means the TPS is very low.
Naturally, in all.
Intelligence is active.
But then, when we are doing something that we like, enjoy very much, then also the TPS is low.
Yes.
Does that mean that we are still in Annamaya
Kosha? No. Naturally, that you are in Annamaya Kosha. Anything you like, anything you are totally enjoying, and if you do it, you are penetrating the time shaft. Anything. There is no worldly pleasure or heavenly pleasure. Everything is one and the same.
Total enjoyment is also okay.
Total enjoyment, which does not make you unconscious. Of course, drinks will make unconscious. That is not total enjoyment. Any enjoyment, anything when you totally which you enjoy is meditation. Utterly meditation, go into it. Don't have any guilt.
Swamiji, when you say I do not know my future, that's fine, I understand. But what do you mean I don't know my past? I think I know my past.
Your thing is right. You think you know your past as you lived, not as it happened. Okay? Not as it happened, as you lived means. When you jump, you go and fall on some incident and fall on this incident. Wherever you fall, only that you remember. You remember only your mother's beating in the young age. Do you remember so much of care she took? No. There are so much of past has happened. You don't remember that. Only what you lived and what you are living, you remember that. Means only where you are touching. This side and that side, you visualize the past shaft is there. You go and touch, come this side, come that side, come that side. Wherever you go and touch and fall, only those things you remember. Not as it happened. Okay?
Swamiji, in NSP there is a rebirth. Is there any context linked to this?
Yes. Your whole, the whole generations after generations is rebirth only. This time shaft only. All your hundreds of past lives and hundreds of future lives which is going to happen is this time shaft only. Unless you penetrate the time shaft, you will be continuously taking birth. The time shaft will go on, go on, go on, go on. Kala chakra, samsara chakra will go on. Hmm.
Now, the time shaft is the same for everybody or a different time shaft for each?
Here comes the time shaft is one and the same. That is why when a man was to stop the time shaft, when you are around him, all your time shafts stop. It comes down. You see, if your frequency usually is 100 TPS, it will come down to 50. If your TPS usually is 80, it will come down to 40. But it will become average. You and me is you plus zero. I am zero. When you and me, you plus zero, average, then what happens? That is why we say, enlightened master nullifies you. Enlightened master nullifies you.
If somebody asked you a question about the how does the TPS rise, and you mentioned sinking into Annamaya.
Enjoying the sufferings of Annamaya Kosha.
But then later on you said both lower and higher pleasures, as long as you indulge completely, is...
When you indulge totally into the pleasure, you don't create pain. When you don't indulge, only then you create pain. Please be very clear, any sweet, any taste, if you intensely enjoy, you will never create hangover. You leave a hangover because you have not enjoyed it. Even when you are, when the sweet laddu is in your mouth, your TPS will be too much. Then how will you enjoy? Unless the TPS comes down, how will you enjoy the laddu? Laddu will be in your mouth, you will be somewhere else. Gombra chutney will be in your mouth, you will be somewhere else. How will you enjoy gombra? No. Unless the TPS comes down, you will not be able to enjoy, even if you have everything. Once the TPS comes down, you will be able to enjoy, even if you have nothing. If the TPS is not down, you will not be able to enjoy anything. If the TPS is down, you will be able to enjoy
everything.
That's all. The whole secret is TPS down.
Nothing else than the Nitya. Then from where I come to enjoy the suffering, I enjoy.
And that is where the problem starts. Actually, there is nothing else but Nitya. But when you start becoming very vague, you start creating an idea. It's like a mist. It's like a mist. How it happens, you can't say. You can say only how to escape. How to escape. You see, when you make a statement, there is nothing else except Nitya. That statement does not become your experience. It's only an intellectual syllabus which you read. That's where starts the problem. Because you do not know what is Nitya, the first statement you make without experience. Let the first statement be made with experience. Then the second statement will not raise. Create a gap between you and your thoughts. That's all. Nothing else. Don't move with your thoughts. These 4 days, try. Simply try. Now, let me tell you the importance of the master's presence. You see, when the master is here, when the he is in the zero state, he is beyond the time shaft, simply when you are around him, you see, when you just attend some programs, you are in 100 TPS. That 100 becomes, what to say, 100 plus 0 is 100. By 2 means what? You come to the 50, average. If you are doing some meditation, naturally you come down to 80. 80 plus 0 is? 40. Then where you come down? 40. Then if you are letting him work on you, means living in his presence, then you become a 60. 60 plus 0 by 2 is? 30. Actually, by totally surrendering, are relaxing to the master's presence, if you totally trust him and relax, he simply stops your time shaft and wipes it.
Wow.
Simply stops the time shaft. His presence can simply stop the time shaft. Simply the presence can stop the time shaft. Just if you relax, simply the time shaft can be stopped. That is what we say. Just by relaxing in the presence of the master, the whole future can be changed. Thousands of people come and tell me, this has happened, that has happened, you helped me this way, that way. How? The time shutters stop. The time shutters stop. Naturally, the past never penetrates into the future. If you are too urging, Swamiji, do it immediately, what will happen? Then what happens? How much of energy I put, what will happen? Because you become, you see, if I put 100%, you become 200%. You sit on the monkey, like a monkey. Then what will happen? You will come down only 100. You will not be less than 100 TPS. So if you can cooperate and surrender and relax, simply the future can be altered or just brushed. It can be altered or just brushed. That is why there is a beautiful sloka which says, Brahma sits with all his sweating, tiredness, goes on writing on your head, your life, your future. Guru just walks and wipes it and goes. Because of the time shaft, this is the way the future is changed. The future is changed. Otherwise, the future can never be changed. The Dharmalingam, he was, according to the time shaft, he was supposed to live throughout his life only as a handicap. Only as a handicap. When he let the eternity to work on him, when he opened up with so much of trust and surrender, naturally, the future is just wiped. The future is just cleaned. Life is moving. That's all. This is the only way all miracles can happen. I think this is the ultimate diagram. This explains the science of miracle, science of meditation, science of ananda, time shaft, everything.
Even samskaras, no, Swamiji?
Samskaras.
There are three movements, Swamiji, actually. There is one, the circular movement, one vertical, one oscillation.
That's what length, breadth, depth. Length, breadth, depth, over. The whole cosmic theory. This whole
cosmic
theory.
These vibrations only imprint samskaras.
No, vibrations are only depth. See, length, breadth, vibrations, depth. Over.
They create the imprints of
samskara. See the vibration.
Yes.
Touching this and touching that.
Yes.
See, when you touch past and touch the future, you exactly reproduce the past into the future because you know only that.
Big put there.
That's all.
That
is what is samskara. That is what I call samskara. Reproducing the same things which has happened in your past into the future is what I call samskara. Is what is? Samskara, that's all. You know only that much. You see, if you are trained to feel the saliva in your mouth, the moment you hear the gongra chutney, immediately the saliva. Naturally, whenever the gongra chutney is brought in front of you, what will you do? Same reaction. So the past and the future moment, if you are trained to get hurt, somebody hurts, somebody criticizes you. If you choose to get hurt when somebody criticizes you, naturally you will be continuously getting hurt whenever people criticize you. If you choose to be happy and relaxed when somebody criticizes you, naturally you will start choose to be happy and blissful. When somebody, it is just your choice. Your choice can help and work if the DPS is less. Your choice, your conscious decisions always brings the TPS down because the force of the oscillation is stopped. You see, not only TPS, you come near the time shaft, not only when the TPS is brought down, even when the oscillation is brought down, when the frequency is brought down, again you come to near the, you understand, you see, if these moments are reduced, naturally the TPS also will become less.
That is what is TPS.
TPS also will be reduced.